got the charts?
Still waiting for that one day. I bring them, you know.
Did I forget?
Yeah, yeah. I bring them. And I'm going to say, see? I knew it was going to happen at some point.
Thank you.
long time, man. Good to see you.
Hey, what's up, man?
Good evening, folks. Just wanted to quickly say welcome to Smalls Jazz Club. It's great to have you out tonight. Thank you for coming out in the rain, and you're in for a treat because we have some great music for you. At this time, I'd like to introduce you to the members of the quartet, and if you could help me welcome them to the stage as I mention their names with some warm applause, we'd appreciate that. How about for Mike King on the piano tonight? Playing the bass, Ugana Okegwo. Please welcome playing the drums tonight, that's Mark Whitfield Jr. And it's our great pleasure to have back at Smalls tonight, starting his weekend run. Please welcome playing the tenor saxophone, Mr. Wayne Escoffrey. It's the Wayne Escoffrey Quartet. Enjoy the music.
Thank you.
Thank you. up, New York. How you guys doing?
That's what I like to hear. I like the energy. Thank you very much. I won't yet. Well, actually, I will. Now that you've met their acquaintance musically, once again, that's Mike King on the piano. Mike King. We're going to Okego on the bass. And Mark Whitfield Jr. on the drums. My name is Wayne Scottfrey. It's always a pleasure to be here playing at one of my favorite clubs in the world, Smalls. And been playing here for decades. That was a composition written by one of my mentors, Mr. George Coleman. I had the distinct honor of awarding him the Duke Ellington Medal at Yale University a few weeks ago. And he was as gracious and charming and as bad as can be. Like that. So that was for George Coleman, called by George. This next song we're going to do is a piece. So we're playing a combination of music from my latest recording, The Humble Warrior, which came out way back, way, way back in 2020. That year. It's COVID year, so it's like two years is like, what, like eight? Something like that. So we're playing a combination of music that I wrote that appears on that album, The Humble Warrior, and also maybe a couple of tunes that are going to be on my forthcoming release that should be out this spring. This next tune is one such composition, and I call this Like Minds. Thank you. This next tune is a composition that I've been playing. Well, I'm playing in this context of late, but I've been playing it for many, many years. One of the things that I'm most associated with is the great music of the bassist and composer Charles Mingus. I've been a member of the Mingus Big Band for quite some time. And this year's kind of special in that this is Mingus' centennial. He would have been 100 this year. So all of us in the Mingus organization have been traveling all around the world, playing a lot of Mingus' music. And it's really been great over the years to have a real intimate relationship with some of his lesser-known works, and also even with people like Cy Johnson, the great arranger who worked with him and his widow, Sue Mingus. This next piece we're going to do is a piece that doesn't get played very much and is one of his lesser-known works. Mingus was known for writing a lot of really intense, challenging, kind of raucous music, but he was also a romantic and wrote a lot of sorrow songs and love songs. We're going to play one of those now. This is actually a piece called Eclipse, and he wrote this in hopes that the great Billie Holiday would one day record it. He even wrote lyrics to the piece, and he mailed it to Billie Holiday, and he never heard a word back. But we are left with a beautiful piece of music. The piece metaphorically tells the story of a mixed relationship during the Civil Rights era. And the lyrics are something like, eclipse when the moon meets the sun, eclipse two bodies together as one. People all around, eyes look up and frown, for it's a sight they seldom see. Some look through smoked glasses, hiding their eyes. Others think it's tragic, sneering as dark meets light. But the sun doesn't care, and the moon has no fear, for destiny has made her choice. This is Eclipse by Charles Mingus.
Thank you. Thank you.
Jr. on the drums. Woo, woo. Nice. I'm gonna play one more short one for you. That was an original composition of mine called Sincerely Yours. The next one is also an original that will be on the forthcoming release that should be out this spring. So look out for that one. We're gonna play this tune that I wrote called Treasure Lane. Enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you, folks. That concludes the set. We'd of course like to first of all thank all of you for being such a great audience tonight, with the beautiful energy in the room tonight and the enthusiasm makes everything so great for the musicians, so we appreciate that very much. We have a sold out show coming in. If you're thinking about sticking around for our next set, let us know. We'll do our best to accommodate you. Otherwise, we hope you had a great time at Smalls and want to come back another time. How about a round of applause for this great band?
Thank you. Thank you.
good evening, everybody. Just want to take a moment to say welcome to Smalls Jazz Club. We're so glad to have you out tonight. Thank you for sharing your evening with us, braving the weather, coming out. And at this time, I'd like to introduce you to the members of the quartet. If you could please help me welcome them to the stage, as I mentioned their names, with some warm applause. And I'm going to start in the rhythm section. Tonight, we have Mike King at the piano. That's Mike King. Playing the bass, Ugana Okegwo. Please welcome on the drums tonight, Mark Whitfield Jr. And it's our great pleasure to have back at Smalls Jazz Club tonight, leading his quartet on the tenor saxophone. Please welcome Wayne Escoffrey. So Wayne Escoffrey Quartet. Enjoy. Welcome.
Thank you very much. Welcome to Smalls. How's everybody doing?
Yeah. I can sense that. I can sense you guys are good. That's nice. I like it. Well, we are here in one of our favorite places to play. We all hang out here all the time. We play here. Smalls is kind of one of our home bases. So welcome to our living room. I know you've already been introduced to them, but now that you've heard them musically, once again, let's hear for Mike King on the piano. Brother O'Kimble on the bass. Mark Whitfield Jr. on the drums. And in case you forgot already, my name is Wayne Escoffer. I've heard some tracks of time. Thank you. That was a composition of mine from my, I guess we're calling it my most recent release, even though it came out back in 2020. And that song was called Chain Gang. We're gonna now play something of our choosing. We've made a decision. we're gonna play an original composition by our bassist. He hides his tunes. He doesn't play his compositions that much. But I made him give me one to play. And it's a good one. This is also from that 2020 release, The Humble Warrior. This is a composition by Ugona Okebo called Undefined.
See the solo just in 5 seconds.
Thank you.
We want our pig wool. Bring it fine.
Let's do Treasure Landing. I need another shot.
You know, 2020 was rough. Speaking to the choir, we all know that, but it was a lot of loss, a lot of sadness, but I think it also brought out a lot of good in a lot of people. We saw a lot of kind of random acts of kindness, which I think we all learned to appreciate and try to participate in. I myself had my situation where a fan of my music graciously offered me his home in Florida for not permanently, that would be really nice, but for an extended period during the pandemic. And it wasn't just a home, it was like a dope ass crib. Pool, jacuzzi, you know, like 10 minutes from the beach, it was fucking dope. So anyway, he graciously offered me his place, you know, for a really extended period of time, and I got to spend a lot of time down there during the pandemic, which was much needed. And a lot of the music that's going to appear on my newest album was composed at his home. This is one such piece. We played it last set, but we're gonna try it again because none of you were here, so we're gonna play it again. This is called Treasure.
Thank you. Thank you.
piece that I wrote. Nah, I write it down. Nah. It was written by the great pianist Duke Pearson called Idle Moments. We're gonna play one more for you, a piece that I did write. This is a piece called Looking for Leroy. The title comes from, it's kind of a nod to one of my mentors, great drummer who used to be in my band for many years. He passed away almost two years ago, I think, of the great drummer Ralph Peterson. And that's it for Ralph Peterson. You guys know Ralph Peterson? You gotta check him out. If you wanna check out Ralph Peterson, you could buy my latest album that was released in 2020. And Ralph Peterson on that record. Anyway, you know, we musicians, we have, we travel all around the world, we go through all these things, you know, we're just sitting on the plane forever, and it's a very special feeling when you come out of the, you come out of baggage claim, you come out, and someone's there to meet you with your sign, with your name on it. Oh, it feels so good. Sometimes that doesn't happen, and it's an issue. But, when it happens, we like that. And, Ralph had a name for that person. You know, he called that person Leroy. It didn't matter if Leroy was like a short, cute girl. It didn't matter if Leroy was like, a big black dude, whatever. Whoever it was, the person's name was Leroy. And when he didn't see Leroy, he'd be like, "Where Leroy at?" So this is a piece that I wrote as a nod to Ralph Peterson. This is called Looking for Leroy.
I'm doing this faster, it's easier.
It's easier for you.
It flows better.
Thank you.
Mark Whitfield Jr. on the drum, Mark Whitfield Jr. Gertrude Wayne Scott is on the tenor saxophone. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you for listening. Thank you for enjoying live music. I always forget to say this, but you know it's very important for us that you guys go on Spotify. You know, you gotta find us, you gotta like us and all that shit. I don't know what you're supposed to do. And then, you know, go on iTunes, get the records. You gotta do all those things for us, all right? So make sure you support live and recorded music, all right? Thank you very much.
His show for the evening. He is back tomorrow night, Saturday night, 7:30, 9 o'clock. First of all, I'd like to say thank you to everyone. Wonderful crowd tonight. Great energy in the room. Beautiful enthusiasm that helps out so much. We love it. And we got a sold-out show coming in. If you're thinking about sticking around with us, let us know. We'll do our best to accommodate you. Otherwise, we hope you had a great time at Smalls and want to come back another time. How about a round of applause for Wayne Scott and his great band? Thank you.